Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Macattack here, and today I'm going to do a little, hopefully a quicker video. It's just going to be talking about a little feature that I discovered recently, and for those who have been playing the game for a very long time, this is probably a very obvious feature. I think it came out about, I want to say 2014, maybe a little earlier than that, but that is the thing of ESP. Now, this does not mean extrasensory perception, even though you might need ESP to figure out how to use it at first. It actually stands for Enhanced Sensitivity Precision. I might have gotten the P wrong on that one. But essentially what it means is that when you have ESP turned on, which by default it is in the game, you will have a easier time targeting your targets as your computer chip sort of takes over your yaw and your bank and such like that to try and sort of make it easier to target your enemy you're aimed at. Now, in the actual gameplay, this just means a couple of things. It means that it kind of bounces around, it kind of slows down the controls when you get close to your target and stuff like that. And you don't really notice it until you turn it off, just how much of a difference it actually makes. So I discovered this by accident because I was just messing around with the controls. But it kind of raised an interesting question to me, because this to me is, it kind of makes the game a lot easier in a lot of different ways. I found when I first came back to this game, I mean, I grew up playing a lot of combat simulators, flight combat simulators and such, but I was surprised at how non-rusty I was when I came to this game, and now I understand why, is because of this ESP system. But the question is, since it is there to turn off, is it really worth it to turn it off? Because the option is there for you to turn it off. Now to do this, I tested, basically did 4 20-minute rounds of Vandal Swarm, ESP on, 2 with ESP off, 2 in the Cutlass armed with M4A lasers, and 2 in the Origin armed with Badger Repeater, just because I find that the M4As are really good if you kind of want to do a bunch of burst shots, and they're very good for precision shooting, while the Badger Repeaters are very good if you just want to kind of shoot like crazy. So after a bit of intensive Vandal Swarming, I discovered a few things. Number one, I need a lot more practice without ESP because it is a lot harder. But when flying with ESP, I found that, surprisingly enough, it was actually harder to aim with. Like, not that it was hard to hit the target, that's easy. You don't even really have to try to hit the target, you just have to get close to it and your ship will automatically aim towards it. But if you try to take over and try to aim at the ship, at certain areas of the ship, it kind of interferes with your computer, and your little targeting system tends to bounce around a lot more in it, which I found really, really tricky. And where does this kind of come down to? Well, if you've gone and paid attention to Star Citizen, you'll notice that one of the biggest features of it is that the ships are in different kinds of pieces. And as you shoot off different pieces of the ship, different systems will work and not work. Now, this can go down to things such as if you shoot off the front left fin of a Drake Cutlass, they'll lose their targeting system to something, or you'll shoot out their engines and they'll lose their ability to maneuver. Some you'll shoot off a wing and they lose some of their thrusters, so they can't turn as well that one way. And if you are a planner and you are kind of trying to figure out how to get the advantage, it's actually very useful to aim and target certain components of a person's ship instead of just trying to overload their engines and blow them up. Because if you're in a larger ship and trying to target down a more maneuverable ship, it helps a lot to kind of know that, well, they can't turn right anymore, so if I stay to the right, then I'm going to be ahead of the game right now. So that being said, when you were in coupled mode, this was really tricky to do because my target kept trying to switch over to the center of the ship, and I did go a lot faster through the levels. I hit about level 6 with the Origin and level 7 with the Cutlass. However, without ESP, I kind of went about level 4 with the I did hit level 5 with the Origin and got about halfway through level 5 with the Cutlass. So a lot of that goes down to my needing, there was a few glitches in the matches, and a lot of it has to go down to me needing a lot more practice on it. For glitches, we had the fact that, well, it's not really a glitch, but it took me about 10 minutes to get used to the targeting system without ESP. And for the second match with the Cutlass, I kind of lost both my wingmen, so I was kind of soloing it halfway down. If I had tied this to the amount of kills, I think that they would have been a lot more even. But yes, time-wise, I was going faster with the ESP turned on, but I think that is mostly a training thing. Now, the question goes down to, is there really a good reason to turn it off? I mean, I mentioned the targeting system, but is that enough to get it to take advantage of? Now, if you're starting out this game or you don't really like doing dogfighting, I would suggest leave the targeting system on. As long as you can survive and dodge, you will destroy your enemies. But where this comes down to a lot more use is if you want to disable your enemies, for one thing. If you are a bounty hunter or a pirate trying to take a lot of loot or something like that, you can't really afford to be aiming for the center of their ship. You can't afford to be trying to blow them up. You have to aim for the wings. You have to aim for the thrusters. You have to aim for their guns. You have to aim for anything that can hurt you or get them away from you. And you can't really do that very well with ESP turned on. So if you're going to take dogfighting seriously and you're going to try and do more than just blow up your enemies, I would really suggest, as soon as you feel comfortable with it, start practicing with ESP off. I think it actually does have a lot of advantages to try and focus on trying to improve that skill, and it does take a lot of more focus to aim with it off, because it's just like, you fly past your enemies so quickly with it, but the aiming is a lot more consistent. Now, this is just with ESP. There's other modes that are also able to add a lot more maneuverability onto it. The one that I've heard a lot is turning off decoupled mode, which basically means that the biggest difference really is that your ship won't instantly stop drifting when you let go of the thruster. It will glide a bit and such, you know, maintain physics a lot better because your flight computer is not interfering with with your motion anymore. So I'll have to look into that one as well, but baby steps. I'm going to first try and master ESP, and then after that I might look into decoupled mode, because that one I have to look into as well if that one has any advantages or not. But what do you guys think down below? Do you guys fly with ESP on, with ESP off? Do you fly with decoupled mode on, decoupled mode off? Any other kinds of options you suggest are a bit of a learning gap, but worth overcoming. I will say this really does break down to the classic Star Citizen thing about making it easy to learn but hard to master, because anyone can really fight with the ESP on. It's not hard to fight with ESP on, but when you turn it off, there is an advantage to turning it off, and it does take a bit of extra work to turn off, and I think that's a good depth to the game there. It's not that a person with ESP with ESP on is going to instantly lose to someone with ESP off, but they definitely do have a lot more options, a lot more flexibility when they have it off. So that's my two cents on ESP. Tell me what you guys think down below. Like and subscribe, share the video, and most importantly, keep on flying.